Hinting, correct? So, just like with the dumbbells, right? I'm here. Catch. Slide it down into my front squat. Boom, slide to the top of the knee. I like going from the top of the knee. As soon as you start messing around the knee, it's tough for kids. It really is. I like going from the floor, teaching from the floor, because it's that start initial from going from a static position. Because on that hang clean, it's a little more counter movement. Well, not every athlete goes from a counter movement position. Say you're coming off the line in football, or a running back, or an offensive player, right? You gotta start from a static position. But where we get the most force production is from that second pull. So that's why we train there. That's where we get the most bang for our buck. So what we focus on is getting up and back. When I'm training the clean, they're gonna start their feet a bit apart. Their feet action should actually just get a little bit wider or slightly move back. Act like they're trying to jump up and back. You'll hear people, Olympic coaches, Olympic people will never move forward. They'll miss all their lifts. And I've heard where repairing in that way, it's actually get vertical. And then I'm moving backwards. So if you watch from the side, my feet are gonna get a little bit wider and then go back because I'm just up and back. Because ultimately I want that bar to travel vertical, not go up and around this way. It's up, come back to me. Does that make sense? So again, side, boom, into that hip hinge position, shoulders over the bar. Okay, I'm loaded on the heels and the balls of the foot equally, but focus on getting that hip extension. So if they struggle with this, say they can't get the clean, they're just hang clean pulls. And then they ride it down into a front squat. Once they catch it, here, have them stand back up, fix their feet if they need to, and then go into that front squat. So a lot of kids,